All right, I'm here at Reynold's Pasture, Paramount Motorcycle Club today. Gonna do a course preview for SECCA Round 1 that's coming up next Saturday on February 20th. This is where you're gonna come in at. I should have taken a left there. That's gonna be closed off. You won't be able to go straight across and send everybody this way. Parking will be out in the field. There's always plenty of parking here. You don't have to get all crowded in or anything. A lot of the Perry Mountain Club members are here doing a lot of work today, so you're gonna see some of those folks in the video. They're working hard to get it ready for Saturday. They always do a great job here. So you're gonna park out in these fields to my left. Ordinarily, this parking up in here is usually club member only parking. So just keep that in mind. However, there are really nice restrooms right there to be open. And sign up is going to be in the clubhouse right here. So you're going to go to the clubhouse for sign up and to get your transponder sticker, pay your entry fee, and all that stuff. So starts are going to be on this side of the creek, which is a little different than usual. But they've got this entire area set up for starts here. You can see the class markers there. They don't have the signs on them yet, but this will be the starting area. As soon as they start, they're gonna send us up a hill to the left. Now right here is going to be a youth split. The youth are going to go that way, and that's what they've got the course set up for, because that race will be first. But the adults are going straight up this hill ahead of us. There's a lot of good hill climbs in this course. If you like hills, you'll like this course. I'm going to take it kind of easy in this first part because there's a lot of rocks and roots and stuff I can't see because of the leaves and whatnot, but that'll get blown off the course really quickly. Now the adults are coming down here and they're going to send us up a rock hill. Now this is a little different than I've seen it in the past, but they're going to make us a hard right here. We're going to go straight up rock hill, so there's a lot of lines here. There's lines that way, but the main course is going that way. There's a reason why they call it rock hill. So this is another kid split. Kids course is gonna join back in right here. They're gonna bypass that hard part. I've been saying kids course. What I really mean is youth course. That's the youth course. Thank you. And Perry Mountain always does a great job with setting up a good course that flows well. There's good single track. There's hill climbs, there's tight technical stuff, there's some open stuff. So, it's a really good course. A couple of housekeeping things just to tell you about. You want to put your, when you go to sign up in the clubhouse, you want to put your number, or you're going to get a number there. You're going to put your number on the left side of your helmet, below your goggle strap. Think about where your goggle strap is going to be when you put it on there. Make sure that the number is visible on the left side of the helmet. Marker. There'll be some slick spots like this. Jumped right out of the main line there. If you have to get a transponder, you're going to stick that underneath the visor of your helmet. So that way it'll read when it goes through scoring. So if you have your transponder in the right spot and your number in the right spot, that'll make it easier on the scoring folks. They always do a really good job. The guys are here working today and they're trying to keep us mostly in the high ground on the property. And that'll help out a lot, but there's definitely going to be some muddy slick spots. You can count on that, so just go ahead and plan for that. The first race of the year is always a little bit crazy, so if you can sign up online and pre-register, definitely do that. In order to do that, you already need to have your transponder and your number. Your transponder needs to be already programmed. You've raced with SECCA before, you've got your number on your helmet, and you're a SECCA member. So if all that's the case, then you can pre-register online. And it doesn't cost anything to do that. There's no reason not to do it if you're eligible. That way, when you get to the race, all you have to do is go to the clubhouse and pay your fee. That's all you have to do. That helps speed things up a lot for everybody involved if you do that. What am I supposed to tell y'all? Oh yeah. Be sure to go to the SECCA Racing YouTube channel and subscribe to the channel. We need to build that subscribership up. That would help out greatly if you do that. We put a lot of links on Facebook and stuff to the SECCA cam footage and to other videos and whatnot. We put a lot of time and work into that, so it would help us if you go and subscribe to that channel on YouTube. Not just watch it through Facebook and stuff. Of course, if you do that, that's okay. We won't be mad at you, but it would help us out a lot if you'd subscribe. Subscriber numbers do several things on YouTube. Most importantly, it helped make the footage better. YouTube applies a lot of compression to small channels without a lot of subscribers, especially channels with under 1,000. So some of those videos are uploaded in high def 1080, but the compression makes them look bad. So getting the views up, getting the likes up, getting the subscriber count up will help with that. It may sound crazy, but that's just the way it is. Glad I got Steve Hollingsworth to fix my suspension recently. I'm gonna need it for this race. How's your suspension? Fast Lap can help you out. Steve's a supporter of SECCA Racing. He's been a sponsor for a long time, so support the sponsors. Those guys that make this, some of this possible. So here's another kid split. The kids are gonna go straight ahead. Adults are gonna go to the left. There'll be a lot of ribbon here on Saturday for each race. Thought I made a wrong turn a little farther back, but I didn't. So, like I was saying, if you're new to racing, we usually have a lot of folks new at the first race of the year. And if you are, I've got 6 videos on my YouTube channel that I've got in a playlist. Tips and tricks, Harescramble tips and tricks. And I've kind of put together those videos over the past few years. So you can check those out. I'll put a link to those in the description of this video. This is a good part of the course here. It's a good single track, some tight stuff. I like this area. Tight single track in here. They've been working hard here, cutting a lot of new stuff. try to keep us out of the lowlands. Been doing a good job with that. It's a good open spot. Maybe to pass somebody that you got stuck behind in some of that tight stuff. Fun little hill climb there. Good downhill right here. There's a lot of lines down it, so watch out for somebody that might have been going down on that. A lot of those areas like that where there's turns where the main trail keeps going, there'll be ribbon up there, so these guys do a really good job of marking the trails. Making them easy to follow. All right. Missed a turn there, no biggie. Mile 6. Some of the Perry Mountain Club members putting in some hard work here, getting everything ready to go. I know I've said it already, but they do a really good job here organizing the races. So when you cross the bridges here, just look across at where you're going. Don't look down at the bridge. Just keep the throttle steady and the bike will go where you're looking. 7.5 mile marker. The course is about eight miles overall. The adult course. And keep in mind, all this could change, you know. These guys, they have to reroute things. Throughout the week they'll do that, so. A week is a long time. So, we're a week out. Well, 6 days out from the race. Today is Sunday, February 14th. Seems like there's something about that date, February 14th. Don't know what it is. Another bridge, there's two lines here. The bridge I just went across, and then there's another grate there. February 14th, what is that? Oh yeah, happy Valentine's Day. Y'all need to thank Wendy for letting me do this today. Promise I'll be home a little bit later, honey. Love you. Happy Valentine's Day. Some guy's gonna skip forward in the video and stop right there, right as I say, love you, happy Valentine's Day, and he's gonna be a little confused. All right, end of the course here. We're not going through the tunnel, taking a left right here, scoring. We'll go through scoring. Right back for the next lap, right back up the hill. All right, Strider course. They've even got the Strider course set up. That's awesome. So most of the kids' course is out here in the grass track. I think some of it may go back into the some of the wooded areas, maybe semi-wooded areas across the creek, but I think maybe there's still some work to be done, or those areas may be too wet. But this is the majority of it right out here